allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, first item is to approve the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, I'll move item three.
Second, Mr. Chairman.
Any questions on the agenda? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item three carries. Item four, approve previous meeting minutes.
So moved.
Second. Moved in second. Are there any questions on the minutes? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item four carries. There are no drainage claims that I got today, so we will skip to item six. Receive and place in file employment status change from part-time to full-time for Spence Schultz effective October 1st, 2017, at the request of Steve Elfridge, jail administrator.
Mr. Chairman, I motion to move item six.
Second. Been moved in second. Are there any questions on this item? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item six carries. Item seven, receive and place in file recorder's reports of fees collected for quarter ending September 2017.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to act on item number seven.
I'll second.
Been moved in second.
Good morning.
Recorder.
Linda Lacasada, Webster County Recorder. I just want to give a breakdown of the fees that were collected and a check that was submitted to the treasurer's office. We collected for Xerox and our recording fees $35,500.50. Breakdown from our revenue stamps, transfer fees, boats, automobiles, and ATV licensing, and our license plates for our county ordinance. We brought in $14,906.17. Our vital records brought in $3,260 with a grand total and a check written to the Webster County Treasurer for $53,666.67. Any questions? And just for clarification, that's just what was brought in for the county's portion.
Okay. The normal question is, did we keep any of that?
No, yes.
Usually don't.
This is the county's portion of what was received.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions on the report for anybody? Or for anybody? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item seven carries. Item eight, approve and authorize the chair to sign Mid-Iowa Development Association MIDAS Council of Governments Agreement for Codification Services.
Mr. Chairman, I move item eight.
I'll second, Mr. Chairman.
Moved in second. Are there any questions on this? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item eight carries. Item nine, receive and place in file 6 month pay adjustment for Mark Lara, Class B equipment operator, at $21.06 per hour, effective October 4, 2017, and payroll dated October 27, 2017, per recommendation of county engineer.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we receive and place on file the payroll adjustment.
Been moved in second. Did Ray need anything on this one?
Just the comment I make for item nine applies to item 10. Employees covered under the road worker bargaining agreement started 80% and it takes 18 months to get the full base pay. And both Mr. Lara and Mr. Davis are working out really well. And so this is their first step increase.
All right, thank you. Are there any other questions on this one? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item 9 carries. Item 10, receive and place in file 6 month pay adjustment for Kurt Davis, Class C equipment operator, at $21.37 per hour, effective October 24th, 2017, and payroll dated November 10th, 2017, per recommendation of county engineer.
Mr. Chairman, motion to move item 10.
Second.
Moved in second. Any questions on this one? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item 10 carries. Item 11, approve and authorize chair to sign agreement for Iowa DOT initiated detour of primary highway onto local roads to complete culvert replacement project on Iowa Highway 175 east of Dakota Avenue between sections 10 and 15, Township 86 North, Range 30 West, Gowrie Township. Said detour estimated to be from March 1st of 2018 to November 30th, 2018, on Route P-29 from Iowa Highway 175 to Route D-60, on Route D-60 from Route P-29 to Route P-33, and on Route P-33 from Route D-60 to Iowa Highway, Highway 175.
It was quite a mouthful, wasn't it?
You may understand that.
Please, sir.
Watch the signs.
Mr. Chairman, make a motion, we act on number 11.
I'll second.
Yeah, move to second. Anything on this? Just get ready for a detour.
Yeah, just we might plan a while ahead of time, and all stated in that motion.
All right. Thank you. Any other questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item 11 carries. Item 12, approve final plans for asphalt resurfacing project FM-CO94-114-55-94, located on C-56 from P-56 east of Vincent Avenue, on P-66 from C-56 north to Humboldt County line, on C-56 from P-73 east to Wright County line, and authorized project to be led by the Iowa DOT on January 17, 2018.
Mr. Chairman, I'll move item 12.
I'll second, Mr. Chairman.
Been moved and seconded. Randy, anything on this one?
Since the DOT is going to let this project on behalf of the county, they utilize our farm market funds, and the deadline is for final plans is next week. So I'm requesting that the plans are here with all the estimate and cost. You need to approve and sign the title sheet, and then that can be forwarded to DOT. And then it'll be let January 17, 2018, and be completed in the construction season 2018. And I don't know if anybody has any questions. Part of the route goes to Badger, and then another step goes north and south to the Humboldt County line. That road goes to Ford, and the other east-west step goes from Vincent due east toward the Wright County line, which eventually goes to Prestige Port Plant. It kind of worked out that how we had our five-year plan and how this Prestige plan is being developed kind of coincided with each other to a certain degree.
I had a property owner, before you turned to Thor on that hill, we had that frost boil problem every year that he says if we start to reoccur again, I think we dug it all up with some rock in it, put a tile in there about 10 years ago. And he thinks that maybe the tile's plugged, or he's wondering if we do, if we were planning on doing anything extra to control that frost boil and come up again.
Okay, I'd have to get with you to get the exact location. We kind of reviewed, before you get these final plans, we review all the structures and all the crossings and everything, and I'll have to give you a...
Yeah.
I think we do have to do a meeting to verify that that has or will be addressed.
Thank you.
Any other questions on this one? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item 12 carries. Item 13, approve time and date for live onsite auction of county-owned calendar shed property, 814 Margaret Avenue, Callender, Iowa.
Mr. Chairman, I'll move item 13.
I'll second, Mr. Chairman.
Been moved and seconded. This is to reset that date, so what do you think we should do?
Well, we talked about it, you know, I think we could do the live auction on the 5th, it's a Sunday. The 5th of November gives us 2 weeks to advertise, and coincide that with the 5th, we could probably do the equipment at the same time. If that worked out for Randy.
Randy, does that work for your equipment, same one?
Yeah, and we'll have to have staff, I probably should have some staff there on that day, so we'll have to...
We could, my wife can do all the clerking and pass out the numbers and stuff, so we don't want to hire anybody to do that.
Sure.
And I think if we had a couple of us there, I don't think...
And a couple of us will be around to stand around.
Sure. So I think we have too many staff.
Yeah, and I think Brad just volunteered to show up for that. Thanks for that.
So we could probably do the county shed and like do that first at 5 o'clock, and that'll take 15, 20 minutes, and then we'll go back to the old hill shed where our equipment sits, and then start that right away. That's daylight savings time that day too, so we'll work on what's your concept. So if November 5th gives you time to have, enough time to advertise, it's probably weeks.
Yeah, for sure, the latest we'd advertise is next week. probably wise to do it about that time, because of the timing of.
Not too early.
Possession of the facility.
That's not too late for them?
I don't think so, it's.
Could we change the date on that, on the possession date, or the calendar said if we had to?
Yeah.
Maybe we could.
The calendar, well, the calendar says that date. So are we worried about that closing date on the calendar, Jim?
I reached out to three of the members from the previous shed, and the 18th, or that tomorrow, whatever's in there, is way too early for everybody there, so is that where we have this 10 days, so that are we out of the calendar? But.
What was it about, like, did they close?
One had not met with banks.
They all have financing.
The other ones have different issues.
And we have to probably have this closed because of our hearings by the 15th, is there any opinion on that? Why could we sell the calendar shed and say we will close on it for December 1st instead of the 15th, whatever? Or since we set the 15th in past hearings?
No, we, well, listeners were part of the public hearing the first time where they stayed November 15th on those. I think we were gonna change the terms.
I guess, can we have all the paperwork done by this, by that sale?
We could have, we would have all the deed done by November 15th.
It's just the buyer, it's the buyer that have to. We're basically selling it, and they have to be able to close within 10 days, and that's probably hard for most banks and stuff.
I mean, you know what I mean, it's. I know the gallery shed, the buyer there, we sure as well, he was asking me if you're guaranteeing the rear title, I won't have an attorney look at it, which I think that's not part of what our sale was, so we have to begin exchange. That's where the delay in that shed is coming.
And this is just my personal feeling, so is that you're gonna have some banks that gave these people these letters, not knowing that, and now they're going to their bank, wanting to borrow the money, and the banks are gonna loan the money on the way they're giving them the title. If, a bank would have a bigger question doing it on quick claim deed than. The banks are gonna have a question, that's all.
So from our perspective, that was all explained to.
Exactly, I didn't, and you know, I know the buyers knew that, I mean, you know how banks work sometimes.
Sure.
Then you go in to actually do it, and.
Exactly.
There's differences. And, I mean, they could be demanded to have a abstract stuff, well, they can't do that, and they can't do that in 10 days. That's all I'm saying, so I just, I'm wondering if there isn't a way to push that, this date farther, but your opinion is no.
Yeah, if we're gonna do that, we have.
We start early on this. Well, then I think we just have to sell it, say it's gonna close by, but I hate to do that.
We only had like three people interested, and I think we should pretty much make them aware that.
Early.
That it's gonna happen.
Their stuff.
Get their stuff.
Well, the other thing is that deadline is set by us.
Yeah.
So if we don't make it, we're not gonna punish ourselves, so.
That's true, too.
They're still gonna want to buy it.
Yeah.
Okay. So your motion is one, November 5th at 1 o'clock?
1 o'clock with the calendar shed and the county stuff right after.
Do you wanna have a open house once again for the calendar shed? Previous time we had a 2-hour lead time. Do you wanna have any kind of lead time?
Half hour, 20 soon.
So do you wanna, I guess you direct me the notice that we need to print that the official auction takes place at 1 p.m. sharp on November 5th, however, there'd be open house from.
12:30 to 1.
12:30 to 1, for viewing and questions and answers and what have you, okay? Clarify that.
And just to clarify, I spoke with the calendar city attorney, their principal, about the shed, and he was in agreement with our position that the land bidder would be able to continue to use the shed in the use that was managed by the county for storage, so if there are any confusion to public potential buyers, that non-conforming use will continue with the sale of the shed.
Is there anything in writing like that stating?
I never got, between the attorney and I spoke on the phone, I don't know. There was, I don't know if there's any action came in that direction on the council.
The question I have is, we have talked about the problem now, but there still is probably a perception out there that it can't fall. And we were talking about ways we could promote the fact that it can be fallen right now. So can we put it in the notice to something, even to the fact that it is grandfathered in that person? So that at least it gets held there to the buyers.
Yes.
More buyers, hopefully.
So it can be used for grandfathered in for storage and, yes, that's what I'm saying.
If you think that's okay, then I would suggest that that be part of the notice.
Yep.
Understand, Brady?
You bet.
Yeah.
I know Brad understands the way.
All right, any more?
No, sorry.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? 13 carries. Move on to item 14. Time and date and location for live onsite auction of used county-owned equipment and materials.
Mr. Chairman, we're setting the date for November 5th and at 4:30.
No, right, immediately upon the counter shed, so maybe 2:00. 2:00.
2:05.
At the old site.
I will be onsite at the old shed.
Would you like to set a time that that's gonna be doable? Hour before?
I think we'll need to have somebody there at 10:00 at another couple hour because.
Right, you're doing that? Yeah.
Have somebody there.
2 hour period.
Yeah, a little bit more, I agree, like just because they'll have to look at all this stuff.
Or if they wanna set something up with you beforehand, you know, a week before somebody's interested in one of the trucks and one that actually wanna come look at it the week before.
Yeah.
They can contact the engineer's office.
Okay.
And is the notice, just for information, have a list of stuff or is it just?
That's a progress in the making, which has not been 100% finalized, but we'll have.
Okay. Because you're getting stuff from the sheriff, you're getting stuff from conservation, it's not just, okay.
We'll have, what, 2 snowplow trucks or 3, big tandem trucks?
Possibly 4.
Four, okay.
So.
Because somebody might wanna come beforehand and actually drive those, you know, before the sale.
Sure, then you can do it.
Yeah.
Anytime, week before, as long as they call ahead, we'll stop by.
So clarification, it's set in an auction time at 2:00 with the property open for viewing at 12:00 or on November 5th.
Or special appointment.
Or by special appointment, call it for a permit. Any other questions on that, Beth? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Vote.
Mark, move it, I'm in here, so.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item 14 carries. Now's the time for the citizens to address the board with anything they have, concerns. Anybody have anything they wanna?
I'm Mike Vine, with Fort Dodge, and I'm 234th Avenue North. I know you guys have vetted the county shed sales for several months. Just as a refresher, if you don't mind, why are we selling these county buildings and what is the plan to replace them?
We already built a new building.
And that will be the only county building?
We still have others out there. This is an updated building out by the county shed.
Right.
Out by the county home. Randy is planning an open house out there at a date in the future, so we can come and look at it. This is the shed. Yeah, we bought the gallery DOT shed, so an updated gallery. And some of the buildings that we were selling didn't fit the uses that we were trying to use them for, so.
So is the one by the old county home and the gallery DOT shed that's gonna be renovated and repurposed, are those gonna be the only two county buildings in Western Valley?
We still have them up by Flair,
Badger.
So you didn't sell all of them?
No, Dayton has one still.
Okay.
Harcourt.
Good enough, thank you.
Some of the ones that we sold were already just storage sheds. The one in Burnside was just storage. And the one to which that was just storage. So two out of the five we already just used for storage.
Thank you.
Anything else from anybody? Board reports.
Guess I've been to a couple of carnival run meetings to cap that off. We had the last meeting yesterday or the day before. Quite a success. I think our team came in eighth out of the 44 teams. They won 3-4 awards. Had a good time. They had positive things about Fort Dodge. It's probably the best. Most people on Main Street for any of the events they had. The banquet was great. I mean, nobody had anything negative to say about what we had. Actually, a couple of participants said that they'll probably come back next summer with their family because there is so much to do on Fort Dodge, they didn't get to see everything. So, I mean, you got somebody from Florida saying they're going to come back to Fort Dodge and you know, ride the OHB park and do some other things that they didn't get a chance to see and do. So, quite an event for Fort Dodge, real good success. Yeah.
The regional landfill board meeting is postponed this month for next month.
Yeah, we do have the ballots in place for the city general, and beginning tomorrow, everybody can start voting in the office. So if anybody wants to vote, come on in, 8 to 4:30 Monday through Friday.
When's the election?
Election is November 7th.
So tomorrow?
Tomorrow, starting tomorrow.
I think the Growth Alliance is having a forum too for that. For the super bowl dates, I think that's probably this week. Somebody's having a forum for the candidates.
Very good. Anything else that could have been a cause? We need to allow claims. So
second.
A move in second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Claims are done. Adjourned.
Move for adjournment.
Second.
All right. We are adjourned. Thank you.